So the best choice here is choice B, lipomyelomeningocele. Let's look at some of the features that make choice B the best answer here. Well, first of all, you have a large defect or mass lesion in the distal canal. You can see on the axial view, there is non-fusion of the posterior arch, so you have a spinal disc ravism. And when you see a spinal disc ravism, the first thing that you want to determine is whether or not they are open disc ravism versus closed disc ravism. And the way to tell is whether or not skin is intact. In this case, the skin is intact, so this is a closed disc ravism. On the other hand, if you see a lesion that's exposed, the skin is not intact, then you have an open disc ravism, and the most common type is going to be choice A, myelomeningocele. And for myelomeningocele, it is a cause or etiology for KRE2 malformation. And here we don't see the evidence of KRE2 malformation. This is a closed disc ravism that's not associated with the KRE2 malformation. Also, you see that the interface between the distal cord, or the so-called neuroplaco, the interface between neuroplaco and the lipoma, is lying outside of the spinal canal. So this is lipomyelomeningocele. If the interface is lying within the canal, that's referred to as lipomyelocele choice E. And often with this type of malformation, you tend to have a cord that's extending all the way very distally, so patients tend to present with tethered cord. So with all the finding, combination of the interface between the neuroplaco and the lipoma lying outside of the spinal canal with the subcutaneous fatty tissue, subcutaneous lipoma, the best finding here, or the best choice here, is going to be B, lipomyelomeningocele. Again, the differences between lipomyelomeningocele versus lipomyelocele is whether or not the interface is lying outside of the canal versus the interface lying within the canal, as demonstrated on this diagram from AJR. Both lesions are closed disc ravism, so the skin should remain intact. Otherwise, there will be myelomeningocele versus myelocele. Those are the open disc ravisms, again, associated with KRE2 malformation. So this is an example of a lipomyelocele. Notice that the lipoma and the neuroplaco interface is inside the canal, unlike lipomyelomeningocele, where the interface is outside the spinal canal. For other choices, we already talked about why choice A, D, and E are not the better choice here. And for teratoma, and I would like to show you a case that has more heterogeneous mass lesion rather than just a spinal cord or distal spinal cord extending into a fatty tissue. So choice C is also not the better answer compared to lipomyelomeningocele. If you have any questions, again, please let me know. Thank you. Good luck on your board exam.